with the exception of when I was playing FF14, which has a custom launcher package as a flat pack, and the random games I play with emulators, all of my Linux PC gaming, which is all of my PC gaming, is done through Steam. So I had been kind of out of the loop with what was going on with other tools and other launchers in this space. Things like Lutris, Heroic, Bottles, and things of that nature. But there is one project that recently caught my attention that has been in development for quite a while and recently hit its first full release. The UMU launcher coming out of the OpenWine Components project. Now, I wouldn't really care about this if it was by some random developer and it was some whole new solution that was going to take a bit of time to be adopted. That's not what this is, though. From now on, I'll refer to OpenWine Components as OWC. This organization is made up of Matthew Commandon, the founder of Lutris, Mirko Bromben, the founder of Bottles, Glorious Eggroll of Glorious Eggroll, Nabara Linux, Powell Lidwin, who is not the lead developer of Heroic, but is a very active developer on it, and this random other person who has literally nothing else on their GitHub account, so I actually have no idea who they're supposed to be, but they are very active in the project. Now, most people involved in OWC have made a couple of commits to the UMU launcher, but the main contributors are GE and this random other person who I have no idea who they're supposed to be. Now, most of the people involved in OWC have made at least a couple of commits to the UMU launcher. Now, like most projects, the gap between the main contributors and the ones who made a couple of commits is very, very big. In this case, the main developers are this random person who I have no idea what the backstory is, and Glorious Eggroll. Now, if the organization sounds familiar, if the people involved sound familiar, if the project itself sounds familiar, that might be because it did go through a very minor rebrand, originally starting as Unified Linux Wine Game Launcher, which is still the name that it goes by, but it also went by the acronym ULWGL, which is a lot more annoying to say, and UMU is still technically kind of, sort of, maybe an acronym that makes sense if you stretch it really, really hard, but yeah, that's just what it goes by now. It's a lot easier to remember. Don't think about it too much. But the important question is, what is it, and what does it actually do? This is a unified launcher for Windows games on Linux, which is what every single one of the other ones is as well. However, there's a twist. It is essentially a copy of the Steam Runtime Tools and Steam Linux Runtime that Valve uses for Proton, with some modifications made so it can be used outside of Steam. Now, when we talk about gaming support on Linux, Proton is usually what is focused on, and this is for good reason. Proton is a very, very important part of the chain. Technically, Proton is a collection of tools. It's Wine, it's some modifications to Wine, it's DXVK, it's a bunch of other things, but Proton is just how that collection is referred to. But the Steam runtime is also incredibly important. Taken from the Valve documentation, this is for Steam Runtime 3 Sniper, but the documentation is the same for basically all of them. Instead of forming an LD library path that merges the host OS's shared libraries with the shared libraries provided by Valve, it uses Linux namespace container technology to build a more predictable environment. This runtime is used for Proton 8.0 or newer, and for some native Linux games such as Battle for Wesnoth, Counter-Strike 2, Dota 2, Endless Sky, and RetroArch, which is technically not a game, it is a collection of tools to run games, but whatever. They refer to everything as games. Basically, it provides a consistent environment for trying to get these games to run. And UMU is taking that and taking Proton and making it run outside of Steam. So, this is what it does. When Steam launches a Proton game, it launches like this. I will put the command on the screen because it's a long command. We can ignore this, the Steam launch wrapper. It's just a process runner with no real value other than forwarding environment variables. More on that later. I managed to pull the environment variables it uses by making Steam run printinf for the game's command line. We needed those inf vars because Proton expects them in order to launch. With them, we can essentially make Proton run without needing Steam at all. Next, this part, the Steam Linux Runtime Sniper V2 entry point. This point in the command right here. The first part, Steam Linux Runtime Sniper, is the Steam Runtime Tools compiled and is used alongside the Sniper Runtime Container used during Proton builds. The V2 entry point is just a bash script which loads Proton into the container and runs the game. So UMU is basically a copy of Steam Linux Runtime Sniper, which is a compiled version of Steam Linux Runtime Tools. We've renamed V2 entry point to UMU and added UMU run to replace the Steam launch wrapper. When you use UMU run to launch a game, it uses the specified wine prefix, Proton version, executable, and arguments passed to it to run the game in Proton inside Steam's runtime container, just like if you're running the game through Steam, except now, you're no longer limited to Steam's game library or forced to add the game to Steam's library. In fact, you don't even have to have Steam installed. Now, the Steam command is obviously very long and very complex and something that you never actually run yourself directly. Instead, it is generated by Steam when you press the play button. The same is true in the case of UMU. This is a shorter command, but it's still quite a lengthy command. It obviously could be shorter if you... Actually, no, it is using environment variables this time, so this is about as short as it is going to get. But again, this is not something that you're ever probably going to run directly. The real value is in the launchers. What does this mean for other launchers? Lutris, Bottles, Heroic, Legendary. Legendary is not one I heard of before planning this video. This is another Epic Games launcher. Everyone can use, plus contribute, to the same Proton fixes. No more managing individual install scripts per launcher. No more, oh, the game works in Lutris, but it doesn't work in Bottles. If it works, assuming something else dumb is not being done, is just going to work. This is why this doesn't have a GUI. It is intended to be integrated into other launchers. This is why all of these people are involved in the project. I don't know why that's the one at the side of the highlight, though. Everyone can run their games through Proton just like a native Steam game. And there's nothing stopping you, if maybe it doesn't work correctly in Steam, to run it through another system and hopefully have it working like that. But having it work as if it was a Steam game is gonna be enough for most games. No Steam or Steam binaries required. If you don't play any Steam games whatsoever, there's no need to go and add the game as a non-Steam game into Steam. The launchers can do their job as the launchers in a unified online database of game fixes, Proton fixes. Right now, Proton fixes packages a folder of game fixes. However, it could likely be recoded to pull from online quite easily. The idea is to get all of these tools using the same UMU run and just feeding their inf vars into it. That way, any changes that need to happen can happen in Proton GE and or Proton fixes or a unified Proton build based off of GE or whatever they want. Now, this is not some maybe possibly theoretical solution where some point in the future it's going to be adopted, some point in the future you're going to be able to use it. Even though it only very recently had its full release, this is something already being used in the wild. As an example, here's someone who, they didn't realize that there was a missing package and it was complaining that UMU was missing. So they got an error about UMU being missing in Lutris. Now, it already is kind of in action already, but what is the basic plan of putting this into action? One, we build a database containing various game titles, their IDs from different stores, and their correlating UMU IDs. So you have a consistent numbering system and not just like, oh, this is the Epic number for a game. This is the Steam number for a game. I don't know if GOG has numbers. This is the GOG number for a game. And it's this whole big mess. You take those IDs and then give it a number that correlates to everything. So if it's in multiple stores as well, you can link between the multiple stores fairly easily. Two, various launchers, then search the database to pull the UMU ID and feed it as the game ID to UMU run alongside the store type, Proton version, wine prefix, game executable, and launch arguments. When the game gets launched from UMU run, Proton fixes picks up the store type and UMU ID and finds the appropriate fix script for it, then applies it before running the game. Proton fixes has folders separated for each store type. The UMU ID for a game remains the exact same across multiple stores, the only difference being it can have store specific scripts or can just symlink to another existing script that already has the fixes it needs. For example, maybe a game on the Ubisoft store, I don't remember what they call it, maybe there's some like issue with that launcher where you need some additional fixes, whereas the Steam version of a game doesn't have those issues. This idea of using Proton outside of Steam has been floated around the internet for a very long time. Obviously, everything here is open source, but I didn't have any idea how tied it actually was to Steam. There have been sort of unsupported and hacky ways to make it happen for a very long time, and obviously a lot of the patches that are applied to things like Proton and then Proton GE do exist with Wine GE. But having something like this integrated into the launcher makes it so much easier to leverage what Valve has built, to leverage all of those incredible changes that has made Linux gaming what it is today. Because yes, there is amazing work that was done before Valve was involved. Wine is a great project, but we cannot deny the fact that things have only gotten better since Valve has been involved. Projects like this is the sort of collaboration that FOSS exists for. Now, I know some people want to deny that competition exists in the FOSS world. It's all open source, we're not competing, but in reality, these launches are competing solutions for the same market share of people, but they shouldn't be competing on that core fundamental getting the games working. They should be competing on the UI features, the additional functionality, and things that make them stand out. Everyone having games that work consistently and work well is better for the entire space. Now, if for whatever reason you need another example of version numbers meaning literally nothing, the official full release is version 1.1.1. Not 1.0, not 1.0.0, not 1.1.1, because it doesn't matter. Also, they don't have an official build for Flatpak or Snap yet, but they do have build instructions right here if that is something you want to do. But what do you think? Do you think a tool like this is actually useful? Do you think you should just add the games as a non-Steam game into Steam? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribesly, BearerPay link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and gaming. What is this?